Oh, there you go. Chief's got one. Chief, I thought you just said that they don't like that color.
Yeah, I only have one.
Oh, you're fishing with the one bait you'd have one color of?
I should have one fish ever cast.
Ooh,
not every other cast.
Nice job.
That's
so, Chief, let's kind of talk a little bit about, we're on a reef here, right?
Yes, we are.
So we're on a reef, it's in the fall, and these oyster reefs are in about 5 feet of water?
Thereabouts, we're running about 4.5 to 5.5 feet. They do like to get up in here. I mean, the oyster reefs are nothing but a big buffet table for these
right.
fish.
So basically, there's a lot of shrimp that hang out here, shrimp, and that's what they're feeding on.
Shrimp, worms, barnacles for the sheephead, just about anything that's edible, it's here. It's like going to the casino and walking down the buffet table.
Sounds pretty good right now. I could use a little breakfast buffet.
But once it cools off, they'll come on up in here, spring and fall.
Yeah. And what's interesting, what's good about these spots is we're on the east side of the river. Mississippi River's at 10 feet. If you're local, you know that's real high for fishing this time of year. But it doesn't take real far off that river before you get in this clean water.
Exactly, exactly. That river's been the bane of our existence this year. A little slow for the trout. We've had a fantastic redfish season, but we're hoping that we can keep on with this clean water now that they're moving up tight and stay on them.
And you can get on these fish and kind of anchor down and catch a few, but what we're doing is we're just kind of drifting a little bit.
We're drifting, setting down when we pick up a few. Do the same thing in other areas too. One of my favorite places is Chandelier. We'll get out there on the grass beds and we'll just drift through once you pick up a few. Put that anchor down and grab what you have. Once it slows down, you're right back into the drift.
There we go.
And a double.
A double. Pretty good.
What we really enjoy about out here is we can get away from the live bait once you get a good bite established.
And
get
look how clean this
plastic.
Water is. Water's beautiful. To be for the river to be as high as it is, that water's beautiful.
Yes, it is.
Let's get it up. And that's what you're going to catch right now. You're going to catch fish that are really, really about this size. You're going to catch them from throwbacks to 14 to 16 inches. Color of baits is sort of you don't know what they're going to do from one day to the other. This is a lemon head matrix shad. I'm throwing it right now. Normally when I'm down here, I tell you to throw black and chartreuse, purple and chartreuse. Well, these brighter colors have done a little bit better, so we're throwing that, and we're using our noisy cork, which is the Four Horsemen. It has that pop to it with the shrimp, and it really helps. So see what else we can do here. But just a real easy setup, about 18 inches under the cork with a fluorocarbon leader, and it's started off good. And what we're doing by throwing the plastic, there's a bunch of sheephead on this reef. So what we're doing by throwing the plastic is eliminating the sheephead bite. Which is not necessarily a bad thing because they're good to eat.
Love them. That's one of my favorite fish for fried fish tacos. I knew better than put that scent on there.
Oh, there we go.
Uh-oh. Sounds like a better one.
Yeah, it's not the right species though.
What you got, a sheepy?
I got a cat. I don't know what I have. I don't think it's the right species. Maybe it is the right species. It's coming up. Oh, it's a foul hook's right species.
Yeah.
It's a foul hook. It's like, that thing's pulling down.
Oh, ooh. Look at that out in front of us.
Big red?
Not sure. All I'm worried about is this trout right now.
Oh,
that's
perfect.
Why I love
that worked out perfect, didn't it?
Took a lot of years to develop that technique.
Make sure to book your next fishing trip with a member of the Louisiana Charter Boat Association. Just go to lasaltwater.com. Got one, Chief?
Yep. Got your notebook, Kevin?
Got my notebook. Oh, you need to take some notes?
Oh. I don't know. My hook has meat on the end of it.
Yeah, it does.
Don't you love that sight right there?
Yeah, it's fun when you can get out here and just start catching them.
That's what I love about plastic. You're not constantly rebaiting.
But you know what? We're smart. And whenever you come out here, Chief, you, especially this time of year, and look, especially the other, another big key to this, Chief, is we're fishing next to one of our partner boats right now, and
yes,
they've got
are.
Live shrimp.
Yes.
And they're fishing live shrimp. So if you're going to be anywhere near somebody that's fishing live bait, you can fish plastic.
Exactly.
But you better have that live bait, because they could just go straight to live bait. So just something you want to remember.
As you notice, we've got it ready to go.
Yeah, we've got it ready to go.
We made a couple of tosses with the live on there too, just to get them started. Once we get that bite established, though, I do love tossing plastic.
There you go.
That would be a trout. Two more fish tacos on the way in.
Chief, this is a pretty vast, talk about fishing on an oyster reef, but this is a pretty big reef, isn't it?
Yes, it is. We're talking many, many acres of these boys.
So is there any particular spot on this thing, or you just kind of drift it until you find a fish?
Well, these trout move around. They're not like a largemouth in a lake or something where they're just sitting. The whole school kind of moves around, so that's why we drift. A lot of times they'll move, and we're so constantly watching the water, making sure we don't see blow up somewhere else and we're not catching. We'll have to adjust our position every once in a while. Oh, missed that one. You get me to talking, I know you're trying to sabotage me.
No, but I'm about to go to
trying to distract you, Chief.
No, but I'm about to go to a shrimp creole with a chartreuse tail, I can tell you that.
Oh, short strike.
I was smart enough to.
Well, that back and forth, y'all were really pounding them with the lemon heads for a little bit, and I was
shrimp right next
to
you.
Then I got down and out, he told me to switch.
Oh, wait.
There we go.
Did that one hit it or what?
He just hammered it.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's
bring
amazing.
Him on this side.
Yeah, let's bring him. I got him right here.
You got
look
it
out
here.
Yep, go ahead.
That's a nice trout right there. Look at him coming up. Dancing in the water.
Fat. Look at that belly.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
They're feeding well this time of year.
Nice one, Kevin.
And like we said, they're feeding on shrimp, pogies, but mostly shrimp right now this time
and
of year.
And another one.
Look, where else can you go? Trevor, you and I were talking. We went fishing last night, so people didn't see that. But you and I were talking, and you were like, I can't believe the number of fish. And look at what we're doing out here this morning. As much as you bass fishing, as many fish as you catch, to come down here, this is still like just so unique for you, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. I mean, the amount of fish you catch, whether it's trout, redfish, the sheephead, I mean, it's incredible. This fishery is probably, I mean, still world-renowned as one of the best, absolutely. I've never fished anywhere like it, you know. We inshore fish a lot in Florida, but we don't have the numbers you guys have here, you know.
And this is a guy that catches a lot of bass and is coming down here and catches a bunch of fish and is impressed by the number of fish we're catching. It's not like he lives in somewhere in New Mexico and or something like that where there's not a lot of fish. He comes from one of the best fishing states in the country. And when you're impressed like this, it says a lot about this area down here. We're just so blessed.
Absolutely. It's an awesome area.
There's no marsh system like this. I grew up in Texas fishing the Galveston Bay Complex, Trinity Bay, East Bay area. And there's some great fish in there. Nothing like here.
It's fun.
There you go, getting me to talking again.
There we go.
There you go.
Got him.
It's like the little ones are coming up close to us. The better fish are out.
Yeah. Now, Chief, this is a spot, well, obviously you need to have clean water because we're not far from the Mississippi River. The river is less than a mile and a half from us right now. So when you come to a spot like this, you need to have clean water. But this is really a fall type spot and maybe a spring spot, correct?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
In the summertime, these fish that are right here are gonna mostly be out here in the Sound. That's more of the Gulf of Mexico and everything out that way. Those fish will be further out. When you come in to the fall time of the year in the spring, these fish move in, and this is an inside area. So I guess you get about 3 or 4 good months of fishing here if you have good water. But that's the key, because the Mississippi River, which is the reason why we have so many fish here, is such a great thing. But when that river gets high, and it gets real high, these areas, depending on tide movement, can get muddy. So you've got to make sure you find clean water. And sometimes you may have to go from here to that point over there to find clean water, but you will.
Mm-hmm. Times when you move about 5 boat lengths and you find clean water. Just depends on how it moves around the shoreline.
LOATV is brought to you by Ralph Sellers, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram in Gonzales, Louisiana's number one Ram dealer.
The biggest thing is not finding the fish, it's just finding their dinner.
Yeah. Whoops.
With these corks, we're able to give it an injured presentation. Unless you're like me and all of a sudden cannot set a hook.
Oh.
Except for that one.
Now, I don't really think that constitutes a hook set. as more of a reel that the fish was just there.
Well, the end result,
I mean, the end result
is that fish hitting the deck.
You know, the end result is good. And this is just some serious fast action out here. What did you just do?
I ran that body down the side.
Tell people what you just did, because that's an interesting thing you just did on your bait.
You're under. Oh. What I did was, as I pulled the fish off the hook, I took that plastic body and just run it up and down its sides. Try to get some of that slime on there. One, it gives it a fishy taste. It gives it a little better feel too. Even though we're using plastics, we're still imitating live. And a lot of times, at least in my opinion, kind of gives you that extra 3/4 of a second that he'll hang on to it to get a good hook set.
There you go.
There we go.
As we saw this morning, we're getting a lot of short strikers. Right. They're just kind of running by. And they'll hang on to it just a little bit longer. Give them a chance to get that hook up inside the mouths.
Now here's an interesting perspective I'd like to ask you, Trevor.
Mm-hmm.
For where we're fishing right now, okay?
I guess it works.
We're fishing in clean water. This is like real clean water.
Yeah.
For down here.
Ah.
For where you are, this would not be considered clean water. So it's funny when you go to different places,
mm-hmm.
if you go to Florida, you're not gonna see water like that and catch trout. But here, and down in this area, in the Mississippi River Delta, this is clean water.
Oh yeah. Well, in Florida, where we fish for redfish and trout, we have a lot of grass. You know, we have eelgrass and different types of seagrass and stuff. And our excellent trout fishing is, you know, with fishing in the grass. I mean, that's
right.
We got to find the shallow grass flats, and because it's got a lot of grass, it just cleans the water up a lot more. But I mean, this is beautiful here, though, considering what we ran through in the river. I mean, this is
looks great. To think that the river is less than a mile and a half away,
incredible.
And you're back out here in this water, it's really good. Ooh, there we go.
There's a fish.
Nice fish.
Is that on live?
Yeah, he's coming in. And Trevor, we talked about this a little while ago. We're making some really long casts.
Mm-hmm.
And if you notice everything we're fishing with here, folks, we're fishing with 7.6, 2.7.6, and a 7.3 Fitzgerald rod. And we got a new series, but before we talk about the series, let's talk about why the rod went so long for these popping corks. What's the advantage?
They just get a lot longer cast, you know? I mean, you can get the cork away from the boat. Like Cheif was saying earlier, it seems like our better fish this morning are coming further from the boat,
right?
You know? So it's important to be able to make a long cast. I'm using the 7.6 medium. This is our new all-purpose series. And it's just got a really soft action, you know, lets the tip load up real nice for popping the cork. And you know, if you get too much with your hook set, it just hooks the fish a lot better because it's got a lot softer tip, you know?
But you see a lot of times fishing with short rods, 6-foot mm-hmm. rods and things like that. You're just not gonna get the long cast with those rods, are you? No matter what brand you use.
No, I mean, just, you know, the longer rod you got to a certain extent, the more leverage you got to get the cork way out there, away from the boat, absolutely.
So that's a good tip. If you wanna cast long, make sure you get a 7-foot or higher rod, and you will notice, especially when you're fishing spinning in a popping cork, you'll be able to cast a mile.
Absolutely.
And catch these. How the Pros Do It is brought to you by Demco, your Touchtone Energy Cooperative.
Hey guys, I just wanted to go over, you know, about choosing the right rod for what your style of fishing. You know, personally, I do a lot of bass fishing and red fishing. I do very little speckled trout fishing, you know, as a hobby. So one of my go-to rods is a 7.3 medium heavy. It's just got a little bit stiffer of an action, you know, for handling bass, redfish, and you know, throwing swim baits, spinner baits. So if you're a fisherman that mostly bass fishes or red fishes, the 7.3 medium heavy is going to be a perfect action for you. But let's say, you know, you're looking for a rod to speckle trout fish and redfish for that matter. The 7.6 medium's perfect for that because it's got a little bit softer tip, you know, especially for popping the cork and stuff, it's got a softer tip. It's just a really good casting rod. It's 7.6 in length, so you can really get the cork way out there. So if you're a fisherman saying you're looking for two specific rods, it's pretty hard to beat these two. 7.6 medium, 7.3 medium heavy, it pretty much covers both ends of the spectrum for you.
LOA TV is brought to you by Soft Science Supreme Comfort Footwear, the most comfortable footwear you will ever wear.
There we go. Feels a little better than what Trevor's been pulling in.
Oh! I would take that as a shot.
I'm just going to stay in his way. I'm not even going to move for him.
Please do. It seems to be working.
You better move.
Mine can't.
I'll get a trout to the face, right?
You know the difference between mine and your trout, Trevor? Mine are going on ice.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, golly. So what did your uncle used to say? If somebody wasn't giving you a hard time, you weren't on a fishing
trip?
You're
not talking smack on the water. You're not fishing properly. That was a man I really looked up to.
Well, apparently at this point, we're fishing properly.
There he is. Got him?
Yeah.
Good job. Now, Trevor, we are fishing today with your new series of rods. And you've got a bunch of different rods. I mean, we got all kinds of series, but this is a new series you're talking about that's really kind of an all-around. And I know a lot of people like cork, and it's got cork. Tell us about what this new series is and the advantages of it.
Well, it's called the all-purpose series, and the reason we named it that is, you know, guys can do so many different techniques with it. I mean, really a guy, like I'm using the 7.6 medium, a guy red fishing, trout fishing, bass fishing even, can use this rod. We do five different models in the casting series and three different models in the spinning series, but it's just a really nice high-end rod, you know, I mean, it's got a nice cork grip to it, just standard casting guides, lifetime warranty, just a great, you know, really well-built rod for anybody, Texas, Louisiana, you know, all the Gulf states, Florida, everywhere. So it's just a good all-around series.
And real quick, not to get into everything because you have so many, but you're talking about high-end. You have different levels of rods. So an entry-level rod starting at about what and then going up to all the way to what? So you have the, I just kind of give folks an idea of price ranges of rods.
Yeah, I mean, our Versa series was considered like our entry-level rod. It's $129 retail.
Okay.
We got 14 different models in that series, you know. And then from there you go to the all-purpose series, the Stunner series, like what you and Cheif are using today, and then the Aqua Dream series as well. But we've got so many to choose from. It can really be overwhelming. So if you guys ever have any questions about which model to choose, you can call us, you can email us, and we'll absolutely answer whatever questions you got about any of the products.
Here we go. Well, guys, I got to tell you what. This, again, you know, every time we come fishing, we always say it's been an amazing day. Whenever time I do a close, and the reason why, because it is an amazing day. Every time you come fishing in South Louisiana, we're in Plaquemine Parish, Buras. What a great time we've had out here today. Want to thank everybody from Raymond to Ike at Saltgrass Work Lodge for some awesome food. Chef Kevin did a great job. Accommodations out of sight at Saltgrass. Great captains, great people. Captain Cheif, as always, my friend. It's always a pleasure fishing with you, buddy. This has been a fun morning.
It's been a great morning.
The only problem is it hasn't been long enough. We've done this in an hour.
That's true.
I mean, it's just what are we going to do the rest of the day? And Trevor Fitzgerald with Fitzgerald Rods and Fitzgerald Fishing. Just check out everything he's got. He's got braid. He's got all kinds of different things. So, and if you want cool shirts too, I like those.
Yep.
Just go to his website, FitzgeraldFishing.com. Check it out. You want to look more? You want to learn more about Plaquemines Parish? Just go check them out as well, Plaquemines Tourism. But I tell you what, come down here, come fishing. Fall is a great time of year, and come enjoy what we're enjoying today. For producer Joey Bordelon, Captain Cheif, Trevor Fitzgerald, I'm Kevin Ford, and for all the speckled trout we caught today, thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next time right here on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.